What's up everybody, welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be taking a look at flight simulators. Now, usually they're pretty expensive, but I found this thing, FlightGear, which looks rather nice and is free too. So let's jump right in and see if we can reproduce all of these amazing screenshots. Alright, so here's the simulator. Wait, what? What is this? What are all the beautiful graphics? And it lags like hell too. What the hell is going on? This looks... and it freezes this often too? And look at this. This is madness. This looks like crap. Why are all those amazing screenshots the way it is? What is this even? Hi everyone, welcome back to Throttle Kitty. We're back on FlightGear again after a month-long break with nothing but my own music to listen to. Do they sound nice? And today, we're going to see what all the graphics options does. I feel inclined to talk about this today because the default settings are tuned for a potato from 5 years ago and doesn't automatically adjust to that shiny new RTX GPU you bought. So without further ado, let's jump right in. We're going to start with the most important setting in the right column. Atmospheric light scattering doesn't just make the sky more beautiful, but activates a plethora of shaders that improve the graphics quality by miles. It doesn't even impact the frame rate that heavily, even on this absolute potato of a computer, so absolutely turn it on unless your computer is very old. The shader level is the other important one. The first few levels don't look that different, but the last two is a significant improvement, especially under ALS. If your frame rate doesn't drop too much, definitely turn it up to full. It's worth it, I promise. Particles and precipitation are a little harder to demonstrate, but if you turn the latter on, you can see the rain outside. Now onto the left column. This is where it starts getting fuzzy and where our poor friends without a graphics card cry in agony, myself included. Because it's all about the polygon count. Pylons and detailed roads are self-explanatory. They only make a difference if you have an OSM2 city object pack, which I have one from Phuket right here. The detailed roads respect each other, and form graceful overpasses if necessary, and have actual cars running on top of them. But they add a bunch of extra details to render, which might weigh down less powerful graphics cards. There are three choices for buildings. None, which would actually activate a shader to simulate a dense city on a city texture. Random, which would sprinkle actual 3D models randomly where the city texture is. And OpenStreetMap, which uses the OSM2 city object packs you downloaded to put buildings where there are actual buildings. Just not necessarily all of them. You should experiment for yourself here. Vegetation is the amount of tree to put in, and is by far the largest frame rate eater I've ever found. On to some unclear settings in the top left section. Point sprites for runway lights is a really old setting that changes the look of the runway lights. Throttle frame rate caps your frame rate to a certain amount to reduce the annoyance of frame rate drops, and compensate field of view changes the zoom calculation and in most cases would zoom out your camera a little. And that's all I'm going to explain for now. I do lots of FlightGear videos among other things, and you can check out more of them on the right side. I'll see you again next Saturday. Have a nice flight.